Good morning, my friends. Coffee with Lilli. Welcome. Happy Monday. So today I wanted to talk about when we have the inability to focus, when it's hard for us to focus, and what it might mean, and also how it feels, because I know this feeling of when it's hard for us to focus, we feel like that something's wrong with us. We feel like, especially for things that we know may be good for us. Like, for me, I had a really hard time, doing things that made me happy because I felt like I was always in this state of like repair. I was always in the state of having to like kind of jumping to the next thing, like the next crisis or the next sparkly shiny thing. And what I realized it ended up doing for me is it ended up really kind of harming me because I really wasn't able to focus on the good stuff that I really wanted to. And yeah, it just made me like really disappointed and sad and kind of angry with myself sometimes because of this thing that I couldn't understand. Like, I knew that I wanted to do certain things. I knew that I wanted to put myself first, but for some reason I couldn't do that. And it made it really hard as well because it actually caused a lot of anxiety within me. But what I didn't realize at the time was that the anxiety was kind of compounding on itself because the physiological nature and the psychological nature of anxiety is that if we are in a deeply anxious state, it is really hard for us to focus on anything because we are either running away or we are fighting. And that requires us to be very singularly focused, which is good, but not good if this thing that we're trying to fight or flee is something that we don't need to fight or flee from. For example, if we're not in physical danger. If we're not in physical danger and we still have chronic anxiety, then that's something that we definitely need to look at because it means that there's something inside of us that is telling us that we need to be in this state. And again, the inability to focus is really hard because it's like we know that we need to be a certain way to succeed, or we've read enough books or listened to enough podcasts, but we still can't seem to put ourselves first or love ourselves or, do these things to have this life that we dreamed of, or even to speak our truths if we're talking about boundaries. So what worked for me and what happened with me is that as I started to understand my deeper rooted anxiety and I started to heal that, what happened was that I started to create this, ooh, a hummingbird. I started to create this space of being able to have enough wherewithal and enough love, internal love for myself. And I just really, the space that you create is really it feels very vast. It feels very expansive. It feels very an alignment and a homecoming to self. And this, the space is in that space that we can make time for the stuff that we really want to do. And if you're in that personal growth, personal development kind of vein, or that's something that you want to prioritize, that may be something to look at, is that the things that you can't do for whatever reason, or that you prioritize later or further down the list, and it's causing this inability to focus on the good things for you, then you may want to look at, how can I help heal this part of me, this anxiety that's really telling me that I need to put other things, these things first, or I need to have this kind of chaotic type environment. Because in reality, and I know this is kind of bucking the trend of society, but in reality, a life, a calm and centered life is the best for everyone. It's the best for you. It's the best for your family. It's the best for society as a whole. It's best for your self-love, your self-worth, for, you know, that life that you are dreaming about, those people in your life that you want to invite into this beautiful existence. It's all possible, but it takes some unlayering and some healing to get there. Hope that helps today.